Greetings and welcome back.
The next morning, King David called together Ariella and his five guardians to discuss their next task. He was pleased with Ariella's mission from the previous night. He ordered his guardians to destroy each of the Moabite camps Ariella had found.
Should we come across their treacherous king, Messa, I will deal with him myself.
Let's go kick some treacherous king ass. A weird thing had happened to this game. Like, Steam claimed that the game wasn't installed, but I think the files, like at least like the X file, EXE file of this game was still on my computer and stuff, so I had to reinstall it. And yeah, apparently the game was there because like I allocated it to the same folder where the game was, and it didn't really have to like download any new stuff. It just had to like realign this game with Steam. So I don't know. I don't think that's this has ever happened before. Would have gotten more mines by conquering Moab. But now the game is working, and like it didn't delete my saves or anything like that, which is really nice. But I don't know if it's something to do with this game or Steam or what happened, but whatever. Do I have some equipment? No, that's good. Whoa, you just rose up. It's like stair or like some elevator stair thingy. I see some guys here, like maybe I can get buff. Those buffer dudes. Boom, boom, boom. Richard Spencer has been in the news again recently. Like, he had an interview. Whoa, that seems like a nice attack. He had an interview with Haaretz, the Israeli news service or whatever it is, and well, he was basically saying like, oh, he wants the Jews to fund the alt-right and the right-wing in Europe, which, well, I think it's just pathetic.
May the Lord bestow blessings.
But doesn't really surprise me when it comes to Richard Spencer.
Your generosity is appreciated.
So, no buff guys. It's only those donation guys, I guess. But yeah, anyway, I was like, thinking about how, well, I thought like the alt-right is supposed to be very critical of Jews, especially like Zionist and Talmudic Jews, and well, Israel is very Zionist by definition. So I don't know, I think he's becoming more and more of a joke, like Richard Spencer. Like, I don't, like, are really people still gonna follow him and listen to him after all of this stuff? Unless he's like doing some really smart play of like, yeah, we don't mind Jews, give us your money, and then he turns on them after he's got their money. I very much doubt it, but maybe that's what he's planning to do. But yeah, anyway, like the
onward
whole white race thing.
Thank you.
Is like
time to shine for the Lord.
I just find it very imprecise or like, you know, generic.
Let's
like
go.
This like white nationalists now, and
time to dull this. Let's crack some skin
and like like what is a white person really?
It is likely that David used the Moabites as forced labor throughout the country.
Like well, Jared Taylor, the, you know, who talks about the white people, who white. And and he is recorded in like there's some video, like some journalist or something asks him like, okay, what do you think about the Jews? And he says, they look white to me. And well, of course, like, yeah, I guess you can say they look white, but is it like, is that the definition of white people? Like, oh, they look white, so they must be white. Like, how does like all of these ethno, like white nationalists, like how do they, like, yeah, ethno nationalists, like I can understand, like, you know, German ethno nationalist wants Germany to be German, or like Ugandan ethno nationalist wants Uganda to stay Ugandan, and you know, that is sounds very reasonable to me. But what is a white person? Like, according to Jared Taylor, at least Jews look white. Maybe he doesn't like mean that they are white, but they look white. And like, is somebody like Sargon of Akkad white? Because I think his, was it his grandfather is black, but he looks very white to me. And like, why, how do they define white? If like this white nationalist, like, is it like, do you have to prove your ancestry to be from a designated white country, like your ancestry to be like six generations back goes, like everybody's ethnically of that country, or how do you, or is it just like, no, Jews look white, okay, they can stay, but I don't know, like, well, I like, there's some, like, I don't know, Italian or Spanish people who look sort of Middle Eastern, so they're not white, but like, if they look white, then they're white, or I how does this thing work? And it's not to say like, because like, I do think there are, I've mentioned this before, but I think there are like differences in different races in human beings, as in other animals. But like, how do you define it? Like, if you wanna, I don't know, propagate the white race, how does it, what are the criteria? Like, let's say like some, well, apparently, Richard Spencer doesn't want this, or like Jared Taylor probably also, but like, let's say like the white people had an ethno state somewhere in the States, like, I don't know, they took, I don't know, Indiana, I have no idea how, why this it is, but it's just something that popped in my mind, like they had their, they started their whiteopia there, like what would be the criteria, and they would only allow white people in. So what will be, what are their criteria for allowing people in? Is it based on the appearance? Is it, is there like some genetic markers? They're gonna do a gene test for everybody, or how does it work? I'm curious. Am I supposed to able, like, there's this thing, the star, am I supposed to burn this place? I guess no. Batom. Hey, that attack is pretty good, and David is dead. Good thing he's an NPC, so nobody gives a fuck. Yeah, I just see this, well, Jared Taylor, Richard Spencer, at best they are like this. David secured Moab. Charlatans who just want your attention for their, I guess, both pride, and they benefit financially from it as well. And he smote Moab and measured them with a line, cast him then down to the ground, even with two lines measured he to put to death, and with one full line of to keep alive, and so the Moabites became David's servants and brought gifts. I guess I came from here, since there's the donation guys there. But yeah, I think that these, well, a lot of these these so-called leaders in the new right and old right and whatever, they're just, yeah, charlatans. They have stuff that, like, you know, when you listen to them for first few times, they sound good, but ultimately they have no real idea what they're talking about. Like, they just say, you know, philosophical sophistry bullshit, and that has very little actual content inside it, and... Wow. This attack is pretty nice. Maybe I should try another character for fun, like this one. Can I buy nurse skills? Bull rush? Shield combo. Okay, let's try this one. Ooh, hook, hook. I don't know what it does. This I have. What's this? Okay, spinny, spinny. Yeah, yeah. Let's go kick some. What are those? Moabite ass.
I can't do that.
Oh, could do that. Oops. Donk. Goddamn, lieutenant guy. This guy doesn't seem so effective, but I guess he's more like a tank or something, since she has a he has a shield. She. Okay, that's effective against that guy.
I can't do that.
No, he evaded me. No. Hey, you. Death comes to everybody, la 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 la. So yeah, if you know answer, is Sargon of Akkad white? Just based on his racial background or something. And yeah, is, because it should be like a scientific issue, like one's race, and not like some arbitrary stuff like a teenage schoolgirl decide, like, now I feel like you are white, but you don't, like your skin is a bit too dark, like, but I don't know, maybe they're just too tanned or something, I don't know. Because since, like, yeah, Obama, of course, is not white. Even though, like, his mom was white. And yeah, like, was it a week ago? Nico Rosberg, he's a Formula One driver. He won the Formula One championship. And his dad is Keke Rosberg. He's Finnish. Like his dad, and he won like the Formula One championship once in the 80s. Like, he's the first Finnish guy who won the championship, so it's a good thing. And now his son won it this year. But Nico Rosberg, he's not Finnish, like, he's German.
By dominating Moab, David secured his position in Edom, controlled more of the king's highway, gathered riches, and had a position in which to invade Ammon.
And he smote Moab and measured them with a line, casting them down to the ground. Even with two lines measured he to put to death, and with one full line to keep alive. And so the Moabites became David's servants and brought gifts. Didn't I just read it in previous cache or whatever? But yeah, Keke Rosberg, he's German, like, I don't, he doesn't speak any Finnish, and I don't think he's actually, like, lived in Finland. Like, I think he's probably visited Finland but like he's not Finnish. Like, just because like, oh, he has Finnish genes or something, like, no, he's not Finnish. Like, I don't know, it's okay, I don't know if like somebody who is let's say a Somali refugee, like we had plenty of Somali refugees come to Finland in the early 90s or something when I was a kid. So let's say like one of those refugees, they have a child and who grows up in Finland and speaks only Finnish and is, you know, inundated with Finnish culture and stuff. Like, I don't know if you can call them truly Finnish, but clearly they are more Finnish than Nico Rosberg, who doesn't even speak Finnish. So it's not like it's not just because of his father's genes, it doesn't make him Finnish. So yeah, it's, but yeah, I don't know if you can call a Somali a Finn either. Like, maybe you can, maybe not. No, I think it's like a bit of a gray area, but definitely they're not like genetically Finnish or anything. But I don't know, like this national identity and race, they sort of go hand in hand, but they are not synonymous. Warriors, but it does not say why,
when, or where it happened. And Benaiah, the son of Jehoiada, the son of a valiant man of Kabzeel, who had done many acts, he slew two lion-like men of Moab. He went down and also and slew a lion in the midst of a pit in time of snow.
I remember I've read this one before, like in one of the earlier levels, like much earlier. Donk, donk, bonk.
I can't do that.
I'm not sure what the hook attack does, but I assume it like this one. I guess it's like, get over here. Get over here. A chest. But I have to destroy all of these jars. It is a jarring task, but it has to be done. I know I am brilliant. My punnage is brilliant. Should I like quickly take a look?
Time to do the let's crack some skulls
of these items.
Let's go.
Let's go.
My axe was good. My axe is ready for battle.
Whoa, this seems effective. Super effective. Is there
time
anybody who benefits? Maybe
let's
still
crack
not.
Some skulls.
Hey, this.
We shall smite them. Let's go.
Don't sound like such a pussy.
We shall smite them.
Oh, this
time to do the Lord's
finally time to shine. Thank you, Maya. Onward for the Lord.
Let's do this.
I thought you'd never ask.
Okay, let's go.
I can't
Oops,
do that.
Wrong button. Oh no, it was an ambush. And they're just like, what? An ambush? I'm shocked. While David kicks ass. Oh yeah, I'm supposed to use the hook attack when I next see enemies. Come on, enemy boy. Enemy boy, enemy girl. Nobody here. Oh no, it's a cutscene. No, it's a comic.
As David and his men returned, after decimating the Moabite encampments, they were in high spirits.
So they drank a lot of alcohol.
Although David was unable to extract his vengeance upon the Moabite king Mesa, victory was still theirs. Little did he know that he would soon get another opportunity. Suddenly, David and his men found themselves surrounded.
Oh no, shocking.
King David, so nice to finally meet you in person. I hope you don't mind that we're using your tent. The sun is dreadful this morning.
Mesa.
You have created quite the dilemma for me. However, I believe an arrangement can still be made.
You will die this day, mongrel.
That's racist.
Now, David, please do not let this discussion devolve into something barbaric. We are civilized men. We can dispense with the petty name-calling. My army may be in shambles, but I do believe I still hold the upper hand in this little affair. This is your niece, yes? Shall I send her to meet the rest of your family, or will you be reasonable?
Ariella!
No!
Now you and your men are going to lower your weapons and surrender. We are all walking out of here, and...
Oof. She's a fucking ninja. I don't know, like... This character is sort of like... in the Hobbit movie, that female elf who isn't in the original, but she's just there to, like, appease the feminists. Because I think they said in the beginning of the game, this character isn't in the Bible. Like, you know, if there was, like, a badass female warrior in the Bible and they depicted her in this game, it's like, okay, but clearly it's just to... appeal to modern sensibilities, and you know, our Bible is sexist.
Helothites, to me. Benaiah, bring me that man's head.
Well, this ought to be fun.
Looks so retarded. It's funny. Okay, I guess I still have to continue. Is there better equipment? I guess this might be slightly better. Whatever. I don't know how still. Like the max damage, is it added to that 1,344 or not? I don't know. Maybe I'll switch, like, let's see how much damage this does with the enemies and then the other one. Hey, you got stuck, you bitch. So this does like... Oh fuck. Hey, there's two giants, and one of them is an archer. Okay, let's see how much this thing does. Okay, I think this is better. Okay, now I can start to fight. Whoa. Hey, don't root me. Come on, let me go. No evading, that's not fair. Why are they, like, immune to my magic effects and stuff? I guess I should use this, whatever it does. Why do I have these special effects for my weapons if they don't do anything?
Can't do that.
I just don't think this makes any sense, like the fact that I have to fight these two bosses alone. Like, what are they, like, is David and the other player character, they're just like sitting on their asses drinking beer and they're like, yes, I put 5 shekels on the behalf of Benaya. I believe Benaya will win. No, it's the bad guys, they will win. Benaya is a complete fucking bitch. Because, like, why aren't they, like, they were, like, ambushed? Like, why isn't the Mesa, is this Melek, okay? Antaria, so there's a, these aren't the king of the whatever Moabites. Like, or are they, like, fighting elsewhere while we are, like, I don't know, scrapping over here? So yeah, well, I don't know, it doesn't make sense military-wise or like story-wise. It's like, I guess I understand it gameplay-wise to have some variety and that I have to use this character sometimes, but it's still, it's just dumb. I despise when common sense is taken away for, like, I don't know, story purposes or like whatever, like contrived situation.
I can't do that.
Aye. Okay, eat some bread. Before you get yourself hurt. Okay, now only Melek. Coffee Melek. I don't know what is Coffee Melek, but it sounded appropriate. Is he like in a rage mode because he has like the red aura? Now he's angry I killed his brother or something.
Can't do that.
Hey, he has, like, yeah, say, I think he has the same attacks as a Cheshire Beam, my favorite character. So he is actually like Cheshire Beam's evil twin. So sneaky.
Can't do that.
Ouch.
I can't do that.
Hey.
I can't do that.
Eat some bread. I have lots of bread, so I don't mind if I waste some of it. Do I like take damage when I'm close to him because of his aura or something?
Can't do that.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, many of these boss fights, they're just tedious. Oh, fuck, wrong button. I was supposed to use this. Like, it's not even challenging, except that, you know, I don't screw up. Like, I don't suddenly, like, take too much of a risk and let my health go down and then he kills me. It's just, yeah. He should have like half of the HP just to, you know, so it wouldn't take like 7 hours to beat one boss. Yeah, yeah, let's just eat some bread. Why not?
I can't do that. I can't do that.
Hey!
I can't do that.
Contrived situation. I cannot move.
Can't do that.
I think I'm stuck. Yeah, so I have to kill him. Okay, now it's like theoretically more difficult.
Can't do that.
Okay, and now he's dead. And I got all the loot. See, yeah, I'm stuck. Thankfully, I got the other characters. Like, let's just say I would be pissed off if I had beat the boss and then I have to go exit and I can't because the fucking character is stuck. That would annoy me. Great deal. See? Malek Spear. Chesobeam likes it. Because they're really on the same side. He's a double agent. Or maybe even a triple one.
Let's crack some skull.
Yeah, I guess I got the bow from Daria. What?
Time to shine. Let's crack some skull.
Yeah, well, who is the archer? This
Let's
guy.
Crack some skulls.
Yeah. Nice. It's a golden bow. I don't know. Maybe I have other equipment, but I'll deal with it later. I have to finish this level now.
With the defeat of the
I guess we have to watch the comic still. Their king. It was time because it didn't like save, so
the Israelite army was ready to return home, as were the five guardians of David.
I will miss you, my brother.
And I you, little sister.
Again we part ways. Farewell and be merciful, my brother, even as the Lord shows mercy on his people.
Always.
You have everything you need.
Of course, my king. My men are just awaiting my orders.
I do not blame these people for their king's mistakes. They will be shown some mercy.
I have a length of rope, per your request. 3 men will lie down and be measured by it. I will put to death a man for every 2 lengths, and allow the 3rd man to live.
That's so merciful.
I leave it to you, then.
By your will, my king.